reviewer Heather Feldstein of wordsbymom.com, and we are talking about some of the activities you can do with your kids over the holiday break so the kids don't drive you crazy, right?
We try.
Awesome. And so you've brought some books along because that's a great way to kind of keep them occupied and kind of keep things calm in the house.
We aim to do that as parents, certainly. A lot of the books I brought kind of inspire activities as well. So, you know, cooking and baking, those are great things to do with your kids. You can read books about baking. This is a fantastic little cookbook, very kid-friendly. You can bake with your kids, cook with your kids, and get them involved in the kitchen. It's always a fun thing to do.
And that's called The Budding Chef. Is there recipes inside there? Or just
there is. It's a cookbook.
Okay.
So there's all recipes in that book, but they're all kid-friendly, and it's stuff kids will eat, and it's stuff they can, with parent assistance, can help make. And so it's a fun book.
Great. And tell me about the one underneath it here.
This is a sweet story. This is actually just a picture book. It's got recipes in it as well at the back, but it talks more about friendship, and it's the elephant's birthday, and she's a baker. And so the mice decide to make her a cake because she's always baking for everybody else.
Oh,
so it's
fun.
A really sweet story about friendship and reciprocity, but there's also a recipe in the back. So, like I said, it inspires baking.
And you've been on before, and we've talked before about how you kind of choose books that, you know, inspire appreciation for other people, diversity, that sort of thing.
Yes.
What other books do we have here?
This is actually a fantastic book. It's called Running Shoes. And at this time of year, I love reading this book. It's about the gift of giving. And it's about doing charitable things for people who are really in need. And so this is a really great book about how one small gift of running shoes can actually change a child's life. And it's fiction, but it's still a beautiful story, a beautiful idea. And over the holidays, you know what? Go through some of your old stuff with your kids. Let them find things that they're not using anymore and donate it. Parents get to declutter and kids get to do something good.
I love that. Inspire the kids, you know, to do something good.
Yeah.
That's great. And how about these two books?
Well, this is Everyday Dress Up. It's a great activity to do with kids as well. It's a book that talks about historical women in history and really important figures in our life and in our world. And you can dress your kids up. It's a great way to teach kids about, you know, historical figures and things like that. Mr. Zinger's Hat is a sweet book. It's about writing a story and creativity and the beauty of that. So why not write a story with your kids? Have them illustrate it, have them write it. And that's a really good activity as well.
I love that. I've seen lots of websites out there, too, where you can actually have your book come to life.
You can.
So that would be so much fun to do as a family.
Absolutely. And then, of course, I brought some placemats. My children made these, actually. It's so simple. You go get Bristol Board. They color whatever they want. They make a placemat, and you take it and get it laminated. And it's you can use them for your holiday meals. And the kids love it. My kids use these every day. I'm sure they're missing them at breakfast today.
And I had to imagine that's fairly inexpensive to do, too.
Extremely inexpensive. Every parent has markers at home. You go get the Bristol board for a couple of dollars. You take it and get it laminated for a couple more dollars, and there you go.
All right, great. Thank you so much, Heather.
Thank you so much.
WordsByMom.com.
You got it.
And so make sure to go there and check it out. Back to you.